Well, thank you very much. And we also want to thank FEL for their financial support. I saw Rebecca a second ago. She's there. She's in New Orleans right now. And I got the opportunity to be here. Several years ago, Rebecca and I were working on different projects. I was working on one in the Philippines. She was working on one in Guatemala. And we were both involved in one, the Tunica project, which FEL knows well about, in New Orleans. And what we realized, and it didn't take long, was that the software that we were using had significant limitations and that it was becoming cumbersome to use. And it was a frustrating process because it was pretty much all that was out there. And as we began to look in further, digging into some of the help pages and the discussion boards about some of this software, we realized that we were not the only ones having these same problems. And so we started talking and we started thinking, and we realized that it's very apropos that we're here talking about Diaspora, because I had people literally from my community that I was working in, living all over the world, wanting to contribute. And there were people scattered across the state of Louisiana working in Tunica, and there were people in different places working in Tachiquel. And so we realized that sometimes you need the people that are working together are not necessarily always in the same place. And so what we began to develop was a software for dictionary making. There's lots of software for dictionary making. Yes, but what we've done is we've made this collaborative, browser-based, and customizable. And this is something that we feel is going to be very beneficial going forward. Let's see, is it this button just? So this CollaLex stands for Collaborative Lexicography. SaaS is Software as a Service. So if you imagine the difference between installing Microsoft Word onto your computer, emailing somebody a file, or you can go into your browser now, you can open up the same file on the cloud, edit it, and the person you're working with sees those changes in real time. That's the difference between traditional desktop software and what we're developing. So CollaLex is collaborative. As many people that you allow into your project can work on it together from anywhere in the world. It's browser-based, which means that it avoids the myriad challenges and limitations of traditional desktop software, which we'll get to in us. I'll remind you of some of those in a moment. And it's customizable, which means you can format your final product to be used, to be displayed or used in several different ways, and in many, basically just the way you would like it to do that. Other stuff out there limits you to how you can do this. We try to give you more customization. Okay, Rebecca?
Yes, thank you, Jared. So what we have accomplished, thanks to being awarded an FEL grant this past year, we were able to complete stage one of our project, which included making the CollaLex website more secure, developing a system for tracking changes, and adding the capability for inline editing that can update now in real time. And in the next few slides, we'll show you some examples of these. Jared, please.
Yeah, so one of the features of CollaLex is that you can customize it completely to exactly how you want it. You can choose whatever fields you want to use in your headwords. You can choose whatever fields you want to use in your senses. You can choose whatever fields you want to use for your morphological forms. Not only that, but you can say whether you want them bolded, italicized, brackets around them. You can order them to the whatever order that you want to put them in your final product. And none of this changes the actual data. It just formats it for when you print it or when you display it on your final product. The other interesting thing about this is it also provides you a constant preview. It's difficult to see here, but if you look there where it says Guapa in the middle, it gives you a constant preview of every time you type something. It shows you exactly what it's going to look like. So I have people in my community where I work that they tell me, I don't know all those fields and everything, but just show me what it looks like and then I can help you. You type it in, it shows you exactly what it looks like. And that's what we call, it's inline editing. Every time you make a change, that change is automatically saved on the central server, which means it's in real time available to anybody else in the world working on the project at the same time. So this is inline editing as well. We have a system of change log system, which means at any one point, you can see who did what. This was one of the things, the features that FEL's support was able to allow us to do, which is very interesting and it's very helpful because if you have multiple people working on a dictionary, multiple people working on anything, sometimes you might need to go back and say, who did this? Why did they do this? Maybe we need to revert back to the previous state, or you basically, nothing happens that gets lost in the process. Also, one of the interesting features about CollaLex is that we do have a system of common word lists. So you'll see up on this, you can actually print out or use, enter into your dictionary from your Swadesh list if you want to do that. We also have the Leipzig Jakarta list. We have the Fox Sibley Egan list. We have several lists from the Philippines. We also have the Gutschkinki list from 1956. And there's a whole list of these that you, if you are interested in these type of things, you also have the word lists. Word lists are also very beneficial in the Philippines in our context because it allows people to get started. It's a great first step when documenting a language. They print out this a list, one that's tailored towards the Philippines. They go elicit the words. All of a sudden now they have their first step. They've taken their first step. They've got 200 words. They can start working. They go in, type those words into the list, and it automatically enters them into the dictionary and displays them when the list gets pulled up. At that point, somebody can call them and say, hey, can you send me a Swadesh list of your dictionary or of your language? And yeah, sure, pull it up, send it to them. There are lots of people today that's still using these things, and not necessarily for lexicostatistical purposes, but for basic documentation and looking for basic words. And the last feature, and this is one that I think is really fascinating and really cool, and that is this. If your lexicon is being edited in real time on a central server, which means it only exists on one place. No, that could be in several actual locations, don't get me wrong, but it's only exists on one central server. Then if you wanted to create a website for your particular project, we could give you the API and the instructions to where you could link your website to the central server so that you could constantly be displaying your lexicon, your dictionary, as it's being developed to the world. And it's instead of having to periodically upload it, literally, I could go in there right now into the word Kakyo. I could make some changes. And when you went to the Bantayanon website, you would see this word and all the changes that I just made immediately. Not only that, but then you could also set up a system of commenting on your website if you wanted to, where the whole world could make comments and say, make suggestions. Very much, not exactly like a wiki, but very much like a wiki. So you've got people all over the world making suggestions, sitting in their homes and laying in bed, eating breakfast, sitting in their living rooms, at school, at an internet cafe, wherever they want to be, and they can be contributing to the work. And this is very interesting in my view and very beneficial, especially when we have languages in diaspora.
Rebecca. So projects so far that are planning to use CollaLex include the Bantayanon language documentation project that Jarrett is part of, also the Kakchikel online dictionary project that I'm working on with a number of other people, a number of other Kakchikel speakers, working to collect the dictionary sources that exist currently out there, also document variation in the language, and be able to have people within the Kakshikel community contributing to all the variants that they are knowledgeable in their in their dialects within the language, and contributing to a variation dictionary for the Kakshikel language. Also, another project that is planning to use CollaLex includes an update of Reyes, Zork, and Prado's 1969 Dictionary of Aklanon, which will be essentially updating that dictionary to reflect more current forms. Next slide. Or Jarrett, do you have anything to add to these? Okay. Other projects that will use CollaLex include the Dictionary of Louisiana French, or more specifically or more accurately, we are in talks of getting the Dictionary of Louisiana French to use CollaLex, as well as the Tunica Dictionary, which is also in talks. Jarrett, would you like to add anything to that?
Those talks do look promising. The Louisiana French Dictionary is finished, but they want to put it online so that it can also be made updated, and it could continue to be developed, which that would be the advantage for them. And then I think Tunica would have the same advantages as well. So.
So our target audience essentially for the software are people who may be new to dictionary building or are looking to begin a new dictionary project for a language or a language variety or for a particular project that involves a language. We also built the software for people who have tried dictionary building before but have been deterred by the learning curve or other difficulties of using available software because of a technological, because of needing some technological knowledge. And this is where me and Jarrett came in, and why we were inspired to begin this project. We also built the software for non-linguists, which can include any number of language speakers who wish to preserve and revitalize their community's language, but might not either have the technical knowledge in the linguistic sense or the technical knowledge in terms of the software sense. And we also are targeting the software for people who have begun to build a dictionary, but need something more accessible, collaborative, online. So what features make CollaLex unique? What sets CollaLex apart? We will have a CollaLex dashboard that is free to set up and use. There are no computers to buy, replace, or upgrade. Users do only need a browser and can access their dictionary and their data and the user interface at an internet cafe, in a workspace on their phones, at a library, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera, on a Mac computer. Sorry. I saw the comment pop up. It can be used on a Mac, it can be used on a Windows or Linux, et cetera. So the particular operating system that you're using does not determine being able to use the software.
Yeah, as a matter of fact, when I first began in Pantayan, somebody gave me two laptops. We put the software on there. I had to buy me a new computer because I had a Mac, and we took these two computers, and then within 6 months, those two laptops were broken and were no longer functioning. We lost data because of that. And we realized really quick that we were kind of stuck. And if you had a Mac, you were stuck. If your computer broke, you were stuck. So it's not that you don't need to have a computer, it's that you can use any computer anywhere. So
other features that make CollaLex unique are that you are able to make real-time updates to a central database in the cloud, which can eliminate sync conflict issues. This format also allows for protection of data from computer or hard drive loss or malfunction. Again, it can be used on any browser and on any operating system. There is no need to install or update software since there will be automatic upgrades done to the server and the database on the online end. And there is also no slowdown as the lexicon grows, and there is also an easy to use interface.
We did a collection one time. We picked up about 10,000 words in a week, the way we did it. And their lexicon went from 1,000 words to 11,000 words. And once we put all those 11,000 words in, it slowed down significantly on your desktop software. Just that was a major problem. So we also have the easy ability to upload audio files and video files. If this doesn't work yet, it's almost there, where you literally pull up your phone, take a picture. I forgot, I don't think that word's in the dictionary. Let me take a picture of that. We upload it, you put the word in, it's there. It's constantly in development and it's constantly improving, which is cannot be said for the one other software out there that is similar to what we're doing. It's no longer in development. Some of you might know which one that is. Anyway, we'll leave it at that. And then one other thing that makes it very unique is CollaLex Live allows projects to display their dictionaries on their own websites in real time, which is, I think, an excellent feature. So instead of having to periodically upload to a separate server or to a different project, you connect to your server on your project, and your website is constantly being updated. This is me. Okay, so next steps, we're dividing into stages 2 and 3. Now, this is not all, but this is the primary points that we would like to accomplish in the next couple of stages. For stage 2, duplicate checks. This is a big deal, and it's very complicated in coding wise. And so we haven't yet got that done. We need to get that done. We also want to put in spreadsheet type editing, so that there's a lot of people that like to use spreadsheets, and they can go in and the view will look like a spreadsheet. They can just tab through very quickly. We've almost got that finished. It's not quite done yet. A redesign of the user interface to make better use of space. And then also task lists and bulk entry, to where you could literally type in a whole bunch, hit send, and it all goes to the same place where it needs to go. If you've heard of rapid word collection, that was primarily an excellent way of entering words into your lexicon. And conformity checks. Does what you're typing in follow the rules that you've set up for spelling and things like this? Stage 3, I saw a question a few minutes ago. We want to do a progressive web app, which will allow you some functionality offline. If there's anything that can be said about this project, about this software, where it may be a small disadvantage, is it can't yet be used offline. So once we establish that, then the software will be able to be used offline. On the fly entries by SMS or Facebook Messenger. A lot of us at least in the US don't know about this, but in the Philippines, this is very common, where you can communicate with a company through Facebook Messenger and the company will respond automatically. So you could literally say, put word in, what's the word? What's the definition? How's it spelled? And send, and the word will go right into the dictionary and be immediately available. So, and you can do this by SMS as well. We'd like to implement that. Also, exportable XML files like Lyft, so that this is, if you've used Fieldworks Language Explorer by SIO, Lyft is their standard XML file format. So we could literally export, and so that you could stick your database or your lexicon into a more developed language desktop software, that so that you could continue to work on it with the grammar and the other type of things that some of the more traditional desktop software offers.
So we just wanted to extend gratitude for having received a Foundation for Endangered Languages grant, which did help us grow our project and lead us down the trajectory that we're currently on. We're very excited for the developments that are to come. And we just want to thank you, all of you, FEL and the rest of you, for listening to our talk. And we also provided our contact information here as well as a link to the website to check out.